Hi guys. So today I want to talk about hair loss. A lot of patients and colleagues have noticed an increase in hair shedding during this really stressful time of COVID and socioeconomic political unrest. So is it really possible to be so stressed that you are literally pulling your hair out? And the simple answer is yes. Hair loss after a period of stress is called telogen effluvium. Today, I'll review the causes and treatments of this type of very common, but very disturbing type of hair loss. If you're just tuning in, I'm Dr. Abby Waldman. I'm a dermatologist at Brigham and Women's Hospital. As a physician, I feel it is my obligation to provide free and useful medical information that you can use in your daily life on social media. If you are interested in improving your life through medical knowledge, then please subscribe. So what is telogen effluvium? Normally, on your scalp at any given time, 85% of your hairs are growing, and that is called the anagen phase, and those grow for about 4 years. About 15% of the hairs on your head are in the telogen phase, and that's the resting phase. That lasts about 4 months, and during that time, the anagen hair growing behind the telogen hair kind of grows up behind it and forces it out, and that's the shedding that you experience almost every day, usually about 100 hairs a day, that you see on your pillow, that you see on your hairbrush. When there is a physical or psychologic stress to your system, your body decides that it really doesn't have the energy to expend on hair growth, and it kind of shuts down that process. So what happens is that the anagen hairs get switched over into a telogen phase. So again, the anagens are the growing one, the telogen hairs are the resting one. So more of your growing hairs get switched into a resting phase. And what you notice is an increase in the hair that you're seeing on your hairbrush, that you're seeing when you put your hands through your hair, or even on in the bathroom, in the shower, or on the pillow. So instead of just 100 hairs a day, you might notice you're losing hundreds of hairs a day, or even 1,000 hairs a day. Depending on the extent of the hair loss, it might be something that you notice, or it might be something that's significant enough for others to notice where it actually causes some hair thinning. So what type of stress can cause this hair loss? Really, almost any type of stress. So it could be psychologic, such as the type of stress we're going through with COVID, going through with our socio-political and economic unrest recently. It can be physical. A lot of women will know this type of hair loss after they've given birth and there's been a big change or shock to their system. They may notice a really dramatic increase in hair loss after that. Other common causes of telogen effluvium, including recent surgery, changing up your medications, or poor diet and nutrition that result in low protein or vitamin deficiency. The hard thing to understand is that oftentimes the hair loss can occur many months after the actual stress, so that if you go through this stressful period, you don't notice the hair loss until maybe 2 or 3 months later. The good news is that telogen effluvium is temporary. Once you've removed the stressor, your hair will switch back into its normal growth pattern and the hair loss will resolve on its own without any intervention. The bad news is that you're gonna have to be patient. It can take a while for the hair to return to its normal growth, sometimes 6 months, sometimes even longer, up to a year. If you haven't noticed any increased hair growth in about 9 months to a year, then it's probably best to touch base with a doctor, even a dermatologist, just to make sure you've ruled out other causes of hair loss. And remember about that 3 month lag time. So even once you've removed the stressor, there still will likely be a 3 month lag before you've noticed any improvement. So don't panic if you don't see immediate results. Besides hair loss, stress can also cause a phenomenon in your nails where you get a little indent in your nails. And it's based on the same principle that really during times of physical or psychological stress, your body just says, you know what? I'm not going to try to focus on making nail. And so it kind of puts that on the back burner for a little bit. And the result is actually a little divot in your nail during the time when you were stressed. And again, that should grow out and return to normal as that stress is resolved. So what can you do to treat telogen effluvium? So the first thing that's easier said than done is remove yourself from the physical or psychological stress, right? Pretty hard to do in some situations. Certainly, those things that are recommended to reduce stress can be helpful and effective. So that includes exercise, it includes yoga, meditation, doing whatever you need to do to sort of remove yourself from the stressful situation. Go through your own history. Think about stressful things that happened in the last several months, including having had surgery, having changed your medication, having had a baby, things that are sort of known to cause this type of physical stress that will cause this type of hair loss. So the other proactive thing you can do is really pay attention to your diet. And that includes making sure that you're getting enough protein, as well as making sure you're getting the vitamins and minerals that you need. The most important related to hair loss includes zinc, vitamin D, and iron. So there are a lot of vitamins and supplements that are dedicated to hair loss. The majority of these include a vitamin called biotin, which is a type of vitamin B. Some of these can have silica and other sort of formulations that are supposed to help hair loss. There are really very little research on whether these are effective, but some patients really feel like they make a difference. I think that it's good to, especially if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, make sure you check with your doctor before starting one of these supplements. And just know that they can be pretty expensive. So just sort of bear that in mind, that the data on their efficacy is not necessarily clear cut. So what about Rogaine? Rogaine is also known as minoxidil. It's sold over the counter as a 5% solution. So minoxidil can be indicated if hair loss has been prolonged and going on for over a year. That being said, it's a little complicated. Once you start minoxidil, once you start Rogaine, when you stop it, you can actually get an increase in your hair loss. And so it's really a long-term commitment. Minoxidil is contraindicated in pregnancy and breastfeeding. And certainly if you're considering starting minoxidil, I would touch base with your physician or a dermatologist before starting, given the long-term commitment. So hopefully all of us will have a lot less stress in our lives going forward and we can all stop pulling out our hair. Please let me know in the comments if you have any questions or concerns regarding stress-induced hair loss, telogen effluvium. Thank you.